Hey guys, I'm Angelo, and welcome back to Crypto Coin Consultants. Among the rise in popularity of all the blockchain protocols is Cardano. But what exactly is it, and how does it work? Today I'll be telling you 9 things you didn't know about Cardano. But first, answer this quiz question. What was the source of inspiration behind ADA, the name of Cardano's native token? Adaptive diagnosis algorithm, Ada Lovelace, automated data analysis, Ada Brown, or another darn acronym? Let us know what you think the right answer is in the comment section below, and stay tuned till the end of this video to find out the right answer. Number 9. What is Cardano? Cardano was named after Girolamo Cardano, a Renaissance polymath and one of the most influential mathematicians of his time. The project is a third-generation blockchain protocol that enables its users to send and receive digital funds, while also supporting the execution of smart contracts, as well as the development of decentralized applications. Its technological design is focused on security, flexibility, and scalability. Through its innovative software architecture, Cardano also aims to find a balance between regulatory oversight and the privacy of its users by giving them the option of attaching metadata to a transaction. Number 8. Why was Cardano created? Cardano was created to improve on the technology brought forth by blockchains like Bitcoin and Ethereum, with 3 operational pillars in mind: scalability, interoperability, and sustainability. One of the most unique and interesting characteristics of Cardano is that all the science and academic research behind it has been and will be driven by some form of peer review. This means that the technology goes through a high degree of scrutiny before adoption, which can greatly limit any future complications. Simply stated, instead of writing a white paper, implementing it, then crossing their fingers and hoping the tech works, the developers behind Cardano decided to take a different route. They re-emphasized the importance of code and proper development. The team worked with universities, took their tech to conferences, and engaged experts from all around the world who reviewed, improved, and agreed upon the Cardano papers before their implementation. Number 7. How does Cardano work? Cardano features a layered design, giving it flexibility and enabling upgrades by way of soft forks. The first layer is a CSL, or Cardano Settlement Layer, which is home to their ADA cryptocurrency. The CSL handles all token-related economics and manages balances. ADA's uses include depositing funds on an exchange, paying for goods and services, entering an application, or sending value between two parties. Transactions on the Cardano network will also be powered by ADA. The CSL will only hold the most basic transaction data, like the number of ADA transferred from one wallet to another. The second layer, called the Cardano Computational Layer, or CCL, is a set of protocols that handle all functions related to smart contracts. The purpose of this layer design is to effectively separate the transaction from the information that comes with it. The layers will allow for more focused updates and better protection of transaction privacy, while communication between them will be handled through sidechains. One notable advantage is that Cardano is built using the Haskell programming language. If you're unfamiliar with Haskell, all you need to know is that it's a more precise code that uses mathematical verification methods, which eliminate human error and enable the system to automatically confirm whether or not the code was written correctly. Haskell will contribute to the prevention of errors and bugs, like those that facilitated the circumstances for Ethereum's DAO hack or the Parity wallet disaster. Governance in Cardano will be based on the blockchain, and its token holders will get to vote on proposed modifications to the platform. A certain percentage of votes will need to be reached before the modification can be implemented. This move towards democratizing the blockchain's future effectively decentralizes governance and will likely contribute to the prevention of hard forks. Number 6. Daedalus. Daedalus is a wallet provided by Cardano's developers that will enable users to send and receive ADA. It was crafted by a team of 9 developers, and it comes with a number of solid features, such as advanced security and unlimited accounting. Daedalus does not hold your keys, effectively giving you full control of your money while also protecting your funds from attacks through the implementation of cryptography. It offers spending passwords and seeds for all your accounts. Wallets can be exported to paper certificates, thus enabling users to place their funds in cold storage for maximum security. Developers will also provide users with the framework to customize certain aspects of their Daedalus wallets, such as themes and plugins. The plan for future Daedalus releases is for it to support multiple cryptocurrencies, a mobile wallet for iOS and Android, an app store, and staking, which will allow users to participate in the block generation process. Number 5. Ouroboros. Consensus is achieved through the unique Ouroboros Praos, which its developers have described as a probably secure proof-of-stake blockchain protocol. It has a modular design with embedded future-proofing, and it's the only proof-of-stake protocol that features mathematically proven security. It'll provide an overview of how the protocol works, but for more information, you should definitely check out the Ouroboros white paper available online. Physical time in Ouroboros is divided into epochs, which are then split into slots. These are relatively short time periods during which a block is created. Slot leaders are randomly elected from the group of total stakeholders, and they essentially perform the same functions that miners perform in Bitcoin. Slot leaders can listen to transactions announced by other nodes, make a block out of said transactions, sign the block, then publish it to the network. Only the slot leader has a right to produce just one block during his slot. Transaction fees are collected in a pool and distributed to slot leaders at the end of each epoch. The election process has been described as a fair lottery because any stakeholder can become a slot leader, provided they hold the minimum required stake. Election for slot leaders takes place through a distributed method of random number generation. Participants generate secret seeds, which, through an algorithm named FTS, follow the Satoshi, are then turned into the identifier for a single specific coin. The owner of that coin then becomes a slot leader. The more tokens you hold, the better your chances are of becoming a slot leader. Sort of the equivalent of increasing your odds by buying a larger number of lottery tickets. Ouroboros comes with some added benefits too, the first of which is that it doesn't require the large computational resources typical of blockchains like Bitcoin, while also maintaining the same level of security. Ouroboros basically runs on the concept of honest majority. If users that own 50% plus 1 of the total stake are honest, that means the blockchain can still operate properly. Another advantage of the Ouroboros design, particularly in terms of scalability, is that slot leaders can maintain blocks on multiple blockchains. This allows for the possibility of simultaneously running multiple epochs in parallel. The developers also plan that, in the future, slot leaders will be using a quantum-resistant signature scheme upon signing a block. Number 4. Tackling scalability. While transaction speed is ensured through Ouroboros, there's still the problem of network bandwidth in order to support the large number of transactions per second. To solve this issue, the developers are proposing a new type of technology called RINA, or Recursive Internetwork Architecture, which can be described as a new way of structuring networks. Nodes will be part of subnetworks, and they'll be able to communicate with one another if necessary, similar to the TCP/IP internet protocol. Another aspect of scalability is handling the constantly growing data. Since data storage is still rather inexpensive right now, Cardano's development team doesn't consider it an urgent matter. Nevertheless, they're working towards the implementation of storage techniques like compression, partitioning, and pruning. Number 3. Interoperability. Cardano doesn't rely on the notion that there should be a single coin to rule them all, but rather envisions an ecosystem that supports a multitude of currencies existing side by side, each with their own rules and protocols. Cardano aims at becoming a sort of internet of blockchains, a platform that understands other blockchains and is able to interact with them without the need for a trusted third party. This ideally leads to a free flow of value across blockchains, and to a crypto world in which blockchains can communicate with ease. Should such an ambitious goal be achieved, the next step proposed by the team is to find a means of making that ideal crypto world compatible with traditional banking systems. Number 2. Sustainability. Cardano seeks to answer an important question. In lack of proper support, how will blockchain development continue once the ICO money runs out? In order to ensure the sustainability of the protocol, Cardano developers have proposed that a portion of every block reward be placed in a decentralized treasury. A consensus vote will determine how funds from the treasury will be used, with the overall goal of improving and upgrading Cardano. Number 1. Who is behind Cardano? The peer review philosophy characteristic of Cardano means that, aside from the core team, there will also be many experts from around the world offering their input, which effectively increases the number of people supporting the project's development. At its core, Cardano is supported by three organizations. The first is a Cardano Foundation, a non-profit organization based in Switzerland, and is tasked with working with regulators, supporting Cardano's users, and promoting Cardano to the greater community. Emergo is a startup incubator based in Japan that will help Cardano integrate with businesses. Cardano has been called an Ethereum killer due to its potential of one day overtaking the platform. The final piece of the tripod supporting Cardano are the brilliant blockchain minds that have also contributed to the development of Ethereum. The company is called Input Output Hong Kong, and it was founded in 2015 by Charles Hoskinson, who is also Cardano's current CEO, and Jeremy Wood, who presently serves as its CSO. Input Output Hong Kong will design, build, and maintain the Cardano platform through to 2020. Hoskinson is a co-founder and former CEO of Ethereum, and Wood is its former executive assistant. Their shared experience can be seen as a major asset to the development of Cardano. So what was the source of inspiration behind ADA? Despite the popular belief that ADA is an acronym for something, the token's name was actually inspired by a person. That person was Augusta Ada King Noel, Countess of Lovelace. She was an English mathematician and writer, as well as the only legitimate child of poet Lord Byron. Ada Lovelace is often regarded as the world's first computer programmer and the first person to understand the full potential of a computing machine. Basically opens up the blockchain to securities offerings that are compliant with government laws and regulations. Polymath refers to its platform as a one-stop shop for securities tokens projects. Its users are provided with a decentralized protocol that enables them to easily trade security tokens in a completely legal manner.